Welcome to the Government Information Services Week in Review. I am Alicia Ali. The island was battered with strong winds and heavy rains this week from Tropical Storm Matthew. The government of St. Lucia is in the process of conducting an initial damage assessment after the storm, which made landfall on Wednesday, the 28th of September. The then acting Prime Minister, Honorable Leonard Montout, worked closely with the Director of the National Emergency Management Organization, NEMO, Felder Joseph, and other agencies in making sure disaster relief was provided and that a full assessment of the situation was done. Minister Montout took an aerial tour of the island on Thursday to get a full picture of the damage. Since St. Lucia was alerted about the weather system on Tuesday, Minister Montout issued four statements. Schools were closed through the 29th of September, that was the Thursday, and Friday the 30th of September. St. Lucia's airports are reopened. Minister Montout called on the nation to keep other islands affected by the storm in mind and sent condolences to the government and people of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, where Tropical Storm Matthew effected serious damage and loss of life. Since the storm, NEMO partially activated the Emergency Operations Center and opened six shelters where 130 persons were accommodated. Residents in affected areas are asked to report damage caused by the weather system to their respective district disaster committees. The Government Information Service, being part of NEMAC, documented the after effects of Tropical Storm Matthew.
to the entire city.
Yeah, man, very, very good.
They've done very well.
Let's give them a snapshot of what we have going on.
Well, the good news is that all of the shelters are now empty, so everybody's gone back to their homes. NEMO is currently, and Red Cross, doing the exercise of inspecting people's individual homes. We had a cabinet meeting yesterday. We invited the opposition also to attend the meeting, to let everybody know, please assist NEMO in identifying the people that were impacted as quickly as possible. In terms of infrastructural damage, way too early. You know, I can tell you there's a big cost because the government did desilting 2 months ago. All the rivers are silted back up again. And we've got to be mindful. What's to say that there was another storm coming quickly behind it? And you did not do the desilting before that hurricane came, it means we're even further exposed.
And that's the Week in Review from the Government Information Service. I'm Alicia Ali.